Hello. Thank you for inviting me to give this presentation. I'm going to be talking today about macaque modeling of antiretroviral prophylaxis for HIV prevention. These are my conflicts of interest. Why is important to use, why NHP or not non-primate models are important to assess them? First, these models can provide proof of concept of efficacy. They can measure biological efficacy versus effectiveness, since we are able to control drug dosing. We can investigate relations between efficacy and pharmacological parameters, such as drug concentration, whether it's systemically or in tissues. We can inform dose selection and regimen modality for clinical trials. And the models can help prioritize drug products, which may result in substantial savings in phase 2B and 3 trials. There are two key considerations for assessing PrEP strategies in NHP models. First, we need to consider pharmacological aspects. It is important that we model clinically relevant drug doses. And if we don't do that, we need to understand what is the translation of those doses. We need to adjust doses based on the difference in size and metabolism between macaques, which is called allometric scaling. And we should incorporate drug measurements at the mucosal site of infection. And this is one of the advantages of this model that led us to collect specimens in multiple locations and understand drug concentrations of how they relate to infection. And then we have the transmission component that is all equally important. The models use physiological viral binocular that mimics HIV infection doses in humans. We need to make sure that we select appropriate species. For instance, pigtail macaques are better suited for vaginal transmission studies or prevention studies. We use an R5 tropic sheep isolate that mimics transmitted viruses. And then one key characteristic is the repeated low dose virus exposure nature of this model. So when we combine the pharmacological aspects and the transmission component, we end up with a model that is highly relevant to PrEP studies. The repeat low dose models that were developed at CDC in early 2000s have predicted the efficacy of Truvada for PrEP. This is the first work that we did with this model. And the table shows the specific PrEP regimen that we investigated, the biological efficacy that was identified in macaques, but different through different routes of exposure, and the efficacy. As just an example, when we look at the daily FDC-TTF in the macaque model, the efficacy was 87% against rectal infection. And when we look at the efficacy in humans with detectable drug, we can see that the efficacy goes between 90% in the panel spread to 100% in the proud study. So, and the same happened with on-demand FDC-TTF, where we model rectal efficacy in the macaque model with the 2+1+1 dose found 94% efficacy. And the hypergay later showed that the efficacy of this intervention was approximately 100%. We not only use efficacy, but we can inform on potential modifiers of efficacy. We've done many studies with TDF through the years, and we've shown that, for instance, efficacy of this combination is not affected by detectable contraceptive. Yeah. We found a very modest reduction of efficacy in macaque infected chlamydia and trichomonas. We demonstrated high efficacy of FDC-TDF against FDC-resistant virus containing the 184B mutation, and we also found partial efficacy against the non-resistant that have K65R. These are very important findings because K65R and A184B are two of the most prevalent mutations associated with acquired drug resistance. So if we look at the prevention spectrum, what we have currently available, as I showed earlier, we've been able to provide proof of concept of daily oral PrEP CPF as well as on-demand PrEP. But we have also investigated products that are in development and have efficacy trials underway. The clinical work has been able to provide concept of this intervention. And I want to focus on oral PrEP CPF and the long-acting cabotegravir. The first study that provided proof of concept of long-acting cabotegravir was done at the Aaron Diamond Research Institute. And this study investigated the ability of injections of cabotegravir that mimic human doses to protect macaques against rectal virus exposure. The study showed high efficacy, but not only that, was able to identify correlates of protection. In this case, when the concentration of cabotegravir were above four times the protein adjusted by C90, the level of protection was 100%. And when it fell to between 1 and 3, the level of protection still was high, around 97%. So not only protection, but also correlates of protection. A more recent study published by our group also investigated the efficacy of cabotegravir using a newly developed repeated denial shift transmission model, and found that cabotegravir was as effective as PCPDF in the model. There was one breakthrough infection in the cabotegravir group, but that animal had a concentration of cabotegravir plasma that was below the protective threshold. I know we all heard the results of the HPTN-083 presented a few months ago, that showed that PrEP with cabotegravir long-acting was superior to FCPDF among MSM and transgender women. And this resulted in a 66% reduction increase of infection with cabotegravir compared to FCPDF. So again, the clinical model using the rectal amplified transition model was able to predict the efficacy of cabotegravir long-acting. There are two more studies that have done with cabotegravir to evaluate, to investigate the efficacy against vaginal challenge. One study published in our group, we showed that cabotegravir was protective in macaques that were repeatedly exposed to low doses of SHIV. And a second study that done at the Iron Diamond showed that cabotegravir was also highly effective in macaques in a different species, in rhesus macaque in this case, that were treated with injectable contraceptive. And in this case, there was also high level of protection. And we heard a few days ago that the HBTN-084 reported very good news. This study was originally expected to continue in 2022. The DSMB that met in November 5th, 2020, found that cabotegravir long-acting was superior to daily oral efficacy. So, expanding the results that were reported for rectal protection out of to vaginal protection. All findings were able to predicted by the clinical study. The next agent that is under clinical trials is oral FTC-TAF. And these are the studies that we published with oral FTC-TAF. First study that we published in 2016 showed 100% protection when animals were receiving this combination against rectal transmission. And a second study that we just published a few months ago showed that the combination of the PCR was also highly effective by infection. In this case, we have a one breakthrough infection in the study, as shown in the survival analysis, but this breakthrough infection was again associated with the little or no detectable which sometimes has happened in pigtail macaques. For some reason, they may not metabolize the drug very much. We know data on FTC-TAF from the DISCOVER trial that was presented at CRO in 2019 and published a month ago, showing that FTC-TAF was as effective as FTC-TAF, a finding that was predicted by the rectal macaque study. We still don't have data in cisgender woman. This is something that is ongoing, so we hope that this same combination is also will also be. So I've described a couple of products that are now in development based on very encouraging technical studies in non-human primates. And I'm going to now move into products that are at various preclinical and clinical stages at this point. And I will touch base on some of these products. The first product that is very promising is islatravir, or ELPA, also known as 8591. This is a first-in-class nucleoside reverse transcriptase translocation inhibitor that has three very unique molecular structural components that make it reverse transcriptase inhibitor, translocation inhibitor, and provides a very long half-life. The first study that was done in rhesus macaque was very encouraging and showed that one single weekly dose of this molecule was able to protect macaques against the PV virus exposure. This was a result that was published a year ago by the Diamond Group, again, very encouraging data. We've been interested in new oral regimens that may improve on-demand modalities over existing on-demand regimens. So we have been interested in evaluating a single oral dose that we use either for PrEP or for PrEP. So we did a willingness evaluation of this modality among MSM in the US and found that the preference was there or there for a single dose either PrEP or PEP compared to daily PEP. So we investigated in macaques the biological efficacy of this single dose PrEP or PEP modality. And the rationale is that now we have much better drugs than when we started discussing about PrEP. We have TAP that has a long persistent PDS impact issue. So in principle could provide extended duration of drug exposure. And we also have integration inhibitor that act at later stages of cycle and therefore are attractive candidates for. So we designed a series of virus challenge experiments where we administer macaques one single dose of PrEP, either 24 hours or 4 hours before virus challenge in the top panel, and found that these modalities were highly effective in preventing infection. And we also defined this same combination as PrEP, administering the doses from 2 to 48 hours after virus challenges, and we saw high efficacy, but definitely the more you wait to administer the dose, the less efficacy you will have. So we demonstrated time response with this intervention. This was a combination that very promising, that included PC, as I mentioned, PC TAP and the integration of L-by. More products in the pipeline, very promising. These are in situ formen implants that have been developed by the Univirus Mass group at UNC. These implants basically form a depot after administration, and then they are slowly degrade and release antiretroviral drugs. Very interesting technology that is currently in evaluation. We've been collaborating with them and show that this drug delivery system is able to sustain drug concentrations. In this case of dolutegravir, for up to 140 days. So very sustainable. Another implant that is very promising is a biodegradable implant in TAP that has been developed by RTI International. And again, we'll be doing some preclinical evaluation of this implant. And this this is again another biodegradable implant, and the graph shows sustained concentrations of tenofovir diphosphate in PBMCs. Three different drugs containing low or high dose for between 12 and 20 weeks of study follow-up. So again, very high levels of tenofovir phosphate above what has been seen daily oral TAP and sustained for several months. So very promising results. Another promising technology are intravaginal rings. In this case are 3D printed rings. These have been developed by Rahima also at UNC. These rings are used for some multi-purpose prevention technology against HIV, HIV, and contraceptive, pritelivir, LNG, and rifampicin. So again, very promising strategy where you can add not only anti-HIV drugs, but also anti-HIV and contraceptives. Another modality that is being currently under evaluation in non-human primates are vaginal inserts containing TAPG for on-demand PrEP or PEP. This is what done in collaboration with Conrad to develop the product. We've been investigating non-human primates, the efficacy of these inserts, either as PrEP or PEP, and the results are very encouraging, so high level of protection against vaginal infection. So in summary, the repeat low dose macaque models of rectal, vaginal, and penile shift transmission has been used to provide proof of concept of daily, on-demand, and long-acting PrEP. The models have been validated by clinical trial results with FDCPF, FDCTAP, and cabotegravir long-acting. Has been highly predictive, so very high predictive value. 7 of the 7 trials have been, the efficacy has been predicted by the repeat low dose model. And can not only inform on efficacy, but can also evaluate potential modifiers of PrEP efficacy under highly controlled conditions. Excellent. exposure to drug-resistant viruses or situations that might be susceptible, such as co-infection with other sexually transmitted infections. The repeat low-dose models is also being used to identify promising second, third generation products. This includes, as I described briefly, novel oral antiretroviral drugs or modalities, biodegradable and removable implants, intravaginal rings, inserts, and of course, multipurpose prevention technology that not only gets the check, but for other students. Finally, I want to acknowledge everybody that has part or is part of this effort. I want to specifically acknowledge the antiretroviral prophylaxis team. Systemic prophylaxis activity is led by Chan Tovar, Ivana, Michelle, and Susan Kenji, and then the topical prophylaxis activity led by Smith, Alia, Tiana, and Don. Other teams of the branch, other than Mike, has also been involved in this effort, the clinical evaluation team, the analytical and clinical, clinical evaluation team, and the diagnostic team, statistical team, and of course, all our, the collaboration that are working with us,